Sirach, chapter 3, starting verse 3. Whoso honoreth his father maketh an atonement for his sins. First off, I want to say, Tawada, Yahawashi, Yahawashi, forgive me the spirit to do this video. Whoso honoreth his father maketh an atonement for his sins. And we know in the Ten Commandments, it tells you to honor your father and your mother. Okay? In this truth, you have to still do the same. You got a lot of guys, when you first come to truth, you be such on fire that through your fire and this truth and learning, you start to puff up against your own parents. And the Lord never commanded you to do that. You have to handle your parents still with honor and respect, man, because those are still your parents. That's why I said, whosoever honor his father maketh an atonement for his sins. He that honoreth his mother is as one that lay up treasures. So Yahawashi Yahawashi still looks at that, man. Okay? I don't care how much knowledge you know. I don't care how much work you do in this truth. When it comes to dealing with your parents, you have to deal with them in a righteous manner, according to the scriptures. You can't throw that out the window because you got this knowledge and now you don't got to do that. No, you have to deal with them in a righteous manner. Okay, we know in Luke 12:51 on down, it tells you about the division. Okay, there's going to be a division. Okay, your mother or your father might not like what you do in this truth and teaching the word. They might go to TJ's church or whatever they believe in. Okay, that's one thing. We get that. But even through the division, you're going to deal with your parents normally, right? So you have to deal with them according to what? According to scriptures. Not according to your own mind because you know the truth and they don't, man. Just feel blessed that the Lord is calling you and gave you the knowledge. Okay? And then you deal with your parents according to that knowledge. All right? So let's read verse 4 again. And he that honoreth his mother is as one that layeth up treasures. Right? So remember, okay? It's considered a righteous work. Verse 5. Whoso honor his father shall have joy of his children. And when he maketh his prayer, he shall be heard. So we know we want Yahawashi Yahawashi to hear us, right? When we pray, prayer is important. So another way to get righteous points for Yahawashi Yahawashi to hear you, okay, is to honor your father and your mother, man. It says, and when he maketh his prayer, he shall be heard. So we know the main thing in this truth is to prophesy the downfall of his kingdom, right? And feed the elect with knowledge. But you can't forget this part of the scriptures because it's written for a reason. Because more than likely you deal with your father and mother still, okay? Even in this truth, even through divisions. So you got to do it correctly, okay? Verse 6, he that honoreth his father shall have long life. And he that is obedient unto the Lord shall be a comfort to his mother. Right. So the Lord is going to bless those situations. Okay. And give you knowledge and wisdom on how to deal with your parents. Even thinking of your nerves, man. Your parents are getting your nerves if you're in the world, man. Okay. So in this truth, if they don't believe what you believe and they kind of got a problem with it. Okay. They're definitely going to get on your nerves, especially at first, because they start seeing you change. Because when you come in this truth, man, you change, man. You become a new person, reborn again. So your parents are going to naturally wonder what the hell is going on with you, man. You're not eating pork no more. You're not doing this, et cetera, et cetera. Verse 7. He that feareth the Lord will honor his father. A man of the Lord. A servant of the Lord. A servant of Yahawashi Yahawashi. That's teaching. That's prophesying. Will honor his father and will do service unto his parents as to his masters. They're still over you. Okay, they're still your parents. You still got to pay respect and reverence towards your parents, man, whether they believe in this truth or not. Verse 8, honor thy father and mother both in word and in deed, that a blessing may come upon thee from them. Right. So even blessings, man, even blessings from your father and your mother because you're treating them righteously. Eventually, they just say, you know what? Our son believes what they believe. We believe what we believe, but that's still our son. And if you act righteously towards them, blessings are going to come upon you because of it. Okay? Not because I said it, because I just read it. All right? Let's jump to verse 10. Glory not in the dishonor of thy father, for thy father's dishonor is no glory unto thee. Right, man. It's no glory unto thee. So if your father lack of knowledge, It's no glory unto thee because he lacketh knowledge. But once again, you got young guys that come in the truth, man. And they might have been competitive with their father their whole life. Now they feel like they got something over him because they know the truth. Now they feel like, well, I'm wiser than him. Now I can talk this way to him. No, man. You still got to show that respect. All right? From there, let's go to verse 12. My son, help thy father in his age and grieve him not as long as thou liveth. And if his understanding faileth, meaning he don't understand what you're into, which is his truth, which is wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, he doesn't understand. Have patience with him and despise him not when thou art in thy full strength. Right. When you come from being the bones in Ezekiel to having flesh on your bones, okay, he might still be the bones, but that don't mean you treat him badly. Okay. He just wasn't chosen to get it. Okay. Yahawah Yahawashi didn't open up his mind, but he's still your father. Okay. That's why it says, and if his understanding faileth, have patience with him and despise him not. Understand that it's a gift for you and be thankful, man, and work on your own salvation, but still deal with your parents accordingly, according to the scriptures, in respect and honor and righteousness. Okay. Verse 14. For the relieving of thy father shall not be forgotten. The relieving, the ease, okay, of thy father shall not be forgotten. And instead of sins, it shall be added to build thee up. In the day of thine affliction, it shall be remembered. Thy sins also shall melt away as the ice in the fair warm weather. It shall be remembered in thy affliction, in the time of Jacob's trouble. You see? So the Lord analyzes that as well, man, that if your parents are in your life, okay, now if your parents don't want to talk to you because of the truth, that's on them, man. And then whenever you deal with them or get a chance to deal with them, then you still deal with them according to righteousness. You don't hold grudges and be wicked towards them, okay? But like I said, it says, in the day of thy affliction, it shall be remembered. Thy sins also shall melt away as the ice in the fair warm weather. Meaning the Lord gonna have mercy, even more mercy ready for you. Matter of fact, when you go back to verse 3, whosoever honor his father maketh an atonement for his sins. That goes right along with verse 15. In the day of thy affliction, it shall be remembered. Thy sins also shall melt away as the ice in the fair warm weather. He that forsaketh his father is a blasphemer. He that angered his mother is cursed of Yahawah. So you don't want to be a blasphemer, man. Okay, so you have to understand how to balance that anger of when you first come into truth, you get seasoned in this truth, you got to balance that annoyance, okay, and the ignorance of our people, even the ignorance of your parents, and wink at it, man, and still deal with it with respect and honor, man, not like you just so over them because of the knowledge that you got and they don't got. So the Spirit wanted me to point that out, man, and the Spirit to remember that. Akim, Yahawashi, Yahawashi looks at that as well, man, how you deal with your parents when you do deal with them, and just do it according to the scriptures. That's it. With that, I want to say, Tawada, Yahawashi, Yahawashi, forgive me the Spirit to do this video. Double honors to the elders of Great Millstone. And Shalom, tell you, Akim, right there, that's doing the truth and sincerity. Shalom.